basement and she's
not here right now. Right in just a couple of seconds.
Okay, and I'm gonna use that.
Yeah,
mic.
I'm gonna hand it to you. Well, happy chilly Sunday morning, everybody. Are you glad to be in the Lord's house today? Come on, let's praise the Lord this morning. Amen. It's great to see you. Folks are coming in. We're going to get started right away. We've got an amazing, incredible day today. You're going to absolutely love these students from the University of Mobile. Let me just ask a question real quick. How many of you have ever seen the group Truth in concert? Raise your hand. Raise it high so we can see. Look at that. All over the place. So you know and you're familiar with Dr. Roger Breland, who is here with his wife Linda today. They're going to be sharing with us. I know people are going to be coming, continuing to come in, but we want to get started this morning. Right now we've got before I go forward, I think we need to give a really big thank you to our greeters and our parking lot crew this morning for helping us out. I think they deserve a standing ovation this morning, don't you? Come on, let's thank them. That's right. Yes. Yeah, that was great work that they did taking care of all of us this morning. Right now we've got a special announcement before we get going any further. Where's Heather? Heather, are you close by? Here you are. I want you to pay attention to this about our ladies' ministry and some exciting things coming up with that. This is Heather. Give Heather a hand this morning, guys.
So my name is Heather Walters, and I am part of the women's ministry retreat that is coming up, the retreat committee. Our winter retreat is this February, just in a few weeks, the 3rd through the 5th. That is a Friday evening through Sunday at lunchtime. And we would love to have all you ladies join us. The catch to this is we need to know by next week. So next Sunday is the deadline for the registration. There are forms out in the lobby. There is a table set up. So if you have not grabbed a form, please grab a form and get it back to either one of the women standing at the table. You can also bring it to the church office anytime this week, but we do need it by next Sunday. So we want to see your faces. We do not want you to miss out on the fun. It is at Epworth, St. Simon's, and we want you to be a part of it. You need the beach in this weather. You know you want to come, okay? So please grab a form.
Thanks, Heather. Yep. All right, good. Yay, Heather. Okay, right now what we want to do is we want to go ahead and take care of our morning offering as an act of worship this morning, kind of getting things going. So everybody, let's stand up together, and I want you to just turn around and say hello to some folks around you and make sure everybody feels welcome just for a minute this morning. Right. Make sure everybody feels loved and welcome. Okay, thank you. You can have a seat. Our ushers are coming forward right now. We want to ask you guys to come on. And we're going to receive our morning offering. If you're visiting with us today, if you're a guest, we're certainly glad to have you. We're glad you're here. Thanks for coming out in the cold. And what I want to ask you to do, we want to try to do a really good job of making you feel loved and welcome. We want to do a good job of extending ourselves to you. And so if you would, there's a tear-off section on the edge of your bulletin. If you would tear that off, give us whatever information that you're comfortable giving. And then after the service, if you would take that to our guest services table, we've got a special gift we'd like to give you. We'd love to do a good job of saying hello. And our pastor will be out in the lobby after the service as well this morning. We'd love to thank you for coming our way and do whatever we can to help you. Let me pray for our offering. Right after I pray for the offering, we're going to enjoy the voices of Mobile. Let me say quickly, Roger Breland has been a friend for 30 years. He's helped so many men like me in the ministry throughout his life, thousands of young men and women across the country that he has invested in and helped. And this is his latest venture with the University of Mobile. These kids are fantastic. And how many of you, just raise your hand, were a host home for them last night? I just want to say a special thank you to you guys for opening your homes up for them and doing that. So I'm going to pray for the offering, and then we're going to give them the entire service this morning. You get to hear me every week, and so I'm just excited for you to enjoy them and for us to worship with them today. I'm going to pray for the offering, then we're going to welcome the Voices of Mobile. Thank you, Jesus, for this amazing day together. Thank you for all that you have planned for us that we don't even know about. Thank you for this incredible group of students. Thank you for Dr. Breland. And Lord, we give you this day. We open up our lives and our hearts to you today. Lord, speak to us. Do what only you can do. And may you be glorified in this time. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, let's welcome the Voices of Mobile.
Oh. It's not conservative or liberal, however they're defined. It's not about interpretation or the judgment of the mind, and it's the opposite of politics, power or prestige. It's about a simple message and whether we believe it's still the cross. It's still the blood of Calvary that cleanses sin and sets the captive free. It's still and preach a word to suit our needs. We can justify sweet subtleties that are wrapped in noble deeds. And we can alter our convictions to adapt to social whims. But we cannot change the gospel or the truth contained within.
Turn your eyes on Him. Yeah. you can't see your way. Some nights are lonely with no one to say. You can make it. This is only a test. You can take it. And don't you think nothing less. So wipe the tears from your eyes. God's on your side. Hold on, don't quit. God's on your side. He can handle it. God's on your side. Hold on, don't quit. God's on your side. On your side.
Some days you're weary
and you can't see your way.
Some nights are lonely with no one to say.
You can't make it. This is all the urgent. You can't take it. Don't you think nothing less?
So wipe the tears from your eyes.
God's on your side. Hold on, don't quit.
Oh,
God's on your side. He can handle it. God's on your side. Hold on.
God's on your side.
Hold on.
in ways I can't explain and can't deny. The little that I have, he multiplies. Just when I feel he won't show up on time, God provides. He'll come through when the clouds of time no more need to fight. Watch God provide. God provides. It's hard to say when there's no food to eat, or what you see feels all the life.
I told voices in the prayer room, I said, you know, our job is to go out and encourage people. And it's really hard to encourage people if we're not encouraged. And these are really nice people, and they're very talented. And they can sing real well, and they're friendly. But if you knew their stories, it's different from just the physical appearance, because half their families are falling apart, and families who've just lost their homes, and siblings who've strung out on all kinds of stuff, and it's just discouraging. And what we realize is that the problems that they live with in their own personal lives are represented into every audience we sing to, because the same things are happening out there everywhere we go. And we do this 11 months a year all the time. But isn't it an encouraging word to hear a song like, hey, God's on your side. Hey, we win. And God provides. We just came back from Cuba. We were there with the Cuban Baptist Convention, and we're working with these highly educated pastors. And they're all just amazing people, and they make $13 a month. And they're lined up down the street to buy eggs. And we go to the seminary and sing, and there are 40 people there working to prepare for the music ministry, and they got one piano. And just amazing people come to know the Lord. Never heard one complaint. Not one. And the pastors live out back of the pulpit in a room with a community bathroom, and and highly educated. It's just amazing. Not one complaint. Hey, God's on your side. And when you get the revelation that God's on your side, hey, and you think about the fact that he's going to prepare us a place, all this stuff down here is just so temporary. You say, hey, God provides. And ultimately, he provides everything, for he is our strength and our way, and he makes our way perfect. And you just kind of have the incentive to say, hey, it's really good to know Jesus. Because he's the way, the truth, and the life. It's a good word. Be encouraged today. God's on your side. And whatever you're walking through, he will provide. We're glad to be at Maple White. We've never been here. I like for them to sing for a while because nobody's ever heard of us. Nobody's ever heard of our university, you know. So when people come in, I just want you to kind of look and pick out the one you like the best, you know. And we just want to kind of look at you and kind of, we don't know what's going to happen. We don't know if God may show up and somebody may get to run in or somebody may get to glory here. We have no idea what you're going to. We just want you to know we're glad to be here. We really are. And we want you to pick out the one you like the best and come by and say hello, and we're going to do you the same way. You know, we're just really glad to be here. And we want you to have more fun than you thought you were going to have. And it's going to be warm in here, and it is out there anyway. So it's just, we're just delighted. We're getting over Christmas, because at the University of Mobile, Christmas is a really big deal. We have this big Christmas spectacular. We have about 10,000 people come. And when that is over, this is just one of 18 different music groups in our music department at the University of Mobile, which is a Baptist school. It's the youngest Baptist school in America. So we have all these groups that travel. But Voices, we do this all the time. Last year we did it like 150 times, you know. And so we do this Christmas tour every year. We did 5 states. We did about 19, 20 concerts. And they just got home Christmas Eve. So we just got back from Christmas, so we're still in that mode. This is about the third time we've sung, and so we still got a couple of Christmas things in us that we'd like to share with you, if that's okay, if you don't mind. And I know Christmas is really big here, too, at Maple White, so this is our rendition of Joy to the World, and it's kind of fun, but our joy is the fact that we're here with you today, and thank you very much for having us here.
To the world, the Lord has come.
Tomorrow we leave for Israel. They've never been. I've been several times, but Stephen's been. Stephen's dad's pastor, First Baptist of Jonesboro. We're going to be there tonight, and he's been as he was there several years ago. But I'm excited about voices going and singing there. We're going to sing in Bethlehem and just all around Jerusalem, and it's a life changing experience. I only wish I had gone when I was their age, and it's a remarkable experience. I know many of you have probably been, but I'm excited that they'll be able to go and sing there. I can't imagine what a 14-year-old girl must have been thinking when the angel appeared and said, "Hey, you're going to be a mother, and Mary would be the mother of Jesus." I mean, she was just 14. I mean, how could she figure all that out? I don't even know. That's hard for me to even conceive. And Joseph, I mean, what was he thinking? He's just a young man. They're not even married. The pain that Mary would endure as a young girl who would, what would people think? The pain of the opinion of people. I mean, the pain of childbirth. She's just a kid. And then the ultimate pain as a mother. To see her son die on a cross. How could she even conceive of what was coming? But God knew. And God had the perfect plan. We sang for some worship pastors this week in a conference in Orlando. And I said, "Hey, we're going to sing this song. You've probably heard it 100 times. I said, you're probably even tired of this song. And most of you know it. But I've been thinking about all that, particularly where we're leaving for tomorrow. And this is our arrangement of that song, Mary, Did You Know?
That your baby boy
would save our sons and daughters.
Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you.
We're going to sing that song next week in Bethlehem. Van auditioned for me this summer. This is the 14th year of the Voices of Mobile. I retired from Truth in 2002 and went to the university. And when people graduate, new people join this group. So this summer, Van came by to audition for me. And when he came in and auditioned, he had a guitar. Well, we do not use musical instruments in this group. We sing a cappella or with musical tracks. Every once in a while, we use a keyboard, but basically, we sing without instruments. So Van said, I'd like to play and sing for you. I said, fine. So Van plays and sings, and he did a great job. So I decided I wanted to invite him to be part of this group. But I wanted to find a song that we could use that Van can play and sing, because Van has a little bit of that old kind of B.B. King kind of twangy guitar that I really like. You know, it's really good. So I found this song this summer. So I called Van. I said, Van, I got the song. I want you to sing and play. Do you know this song? He said, it's the ringtone on my phone. I thought, he's got it. He's got it. Well, one of our favorite places to play in Mobile is the Mount Hebron Baptist Church. It is the largest Baptist church in Mobile. It is an African-American church. And I'm telling you right now, they have more fun than you do because they know how to worship. Now, Van's dad is pastor of a Baptist church in Mobile. Now, Chris is here. Where's Chris? Chris's dad is pastor of a Southern Baptist church. He does church plants in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Both Van and Chris have more fun in church than we do. Chris dances all the time. If you've seen him on the stage, he dances. He dances at school. He dances going to class. Chris just loves music. It's just in him. And JR's dad, for instance, is a worship pastor at First Baptist Columbia, Tennessee. JR cannot dance at all. And we put him between Van and Chris on the stage, and JR is still a white Baptist. That's what he is, you know. So as we sing this song, now, we've got some brothers and sisters here, but most of you are white. So I want to ask you not to be so white on this song. And if you won't be so white and talk to us like they do at Mount Hebron, we will have a lot more fun on this song. And when we sang it at Mount, I mean, Van became an instant star because they know this song as well as Van. And we just stood up there looking awfully white as they sang this song. But it was so much fun. It was wonderful, and we loved it. The title of Van's song is Happy.
You know, the truth can hurt you, and the truth can also change you. But the question is, what would truth do to you?
I just wanna be happy. If I keep on doing the things that keep on bringing me pain, there's no one else I can blame if I'm not happy. Wasted time, but now I can see the biggest enemy is me. So I'm not happy.
Now see, you can
cry yourself to sleep,
and you can even
shout and raise your hand.
But the truth is that
it won't change a thing, child, until you understand.
See, don't get stuck in how you feel.
Don't get stuck in how you
see,
feel.
Jesus, take the wheel.
Jesus, take the
because
wheel.
He knows the road.
Knows the road that you need to take.
But it only works if
you want to be happy.
Just look at yourself and say that.
Don't you want to be happy?
But if I keep on giving my heart,
but if I keep on giving my heart
for people
to tear apart,
this healing that I need,
the healing will never start, so I can be happy. Will I ever be happy?
Now see, you can
cry yourself to sleep,
and you can even
shout and raise your hand.
But the truth is that
it won't change a thing, child, until you understand.
Yourself and say that.
I just wanna be happy.
Now, if you really mean that, I just need everybody while you're standing to clap your hands and say yes right here.
You say yeah, yeah, yeah.
If you're tired of going to the same circle, let me hear you say it.
You say yeah,
say yeah,
yeah, yeah.
If you're tired of making the same mistakes, let me hear you say it.
You say yeah,
say yeah,
yeah, yeah.
So open up your heart and say yes today.
Let me hear you say yeah,
say yeah.
Circle, just say, yes, Lord. Every day, ask yourself that question. See, all you have to do is just pull over and let Him drive. Proverbs 18 and 16 says that a man's gift will make room for him and put him in the presence of great men.
Thank you, Van. Good job. Thank you, folks. Hey, our time is kind of we're going to do two songs. We're going to sing one song, and then there'll be a time of offering for voices. Then we'll sing another song at the end. But you've been such a nice audience. Scott, I'm so glad that we could be here. Pastor, thank you for letting us come. Y'all kind of have fun here, too. That's good. I really like that. I didn't know what to expect. Scott, thank you so much for all you've done for us. Thank you. I know it's a fun place, but if, pardon our ignorance, we just didn't know, folks. I was maybe white at the other location many, many years ago with Truth, and we had a great time. So thank you for being kind to us. There'll be a love offering for voices, and I want to tell you where it's going. I learned a long time ago, I've been doing this 45 years. The worst thing in the world you can do is get up in a Baptist church and beg for money, because Baptists don't like that. So I don't do that. But here's what we do. The Voices of Mobile from the University of Mobile, and they do not support financially anything we do because they can't afford to do that. So anything we do, we raise our own support. I mean, totally, 100%. So if we go anywhere, we raise it. So here's what happens here. There's a bus out front. Mr. Jimmy owns it, and he drives for us. He's been doing that for a long, long time. It costs us $1,200 a day. So if the offering's $1,205, we get $5. But we have to pay for that bus. And tomorrow we go to Israel, we pay our own way. So if the offering could be somewhere around $15,000, $18,000, we'd really appreciate it this morning. That's what it'd be good for us to do. But I just wanted you to know where it's going. People here have been very kind to us. Thank you for what you do. Thank you for what you've done. We appreciate this opportunity. It's a privilege for us to be here. And how we receive the offering, they will tell Scott or Pastor will come. They'll explain how to do that. So we're going to sing this song, then they'll come, and then we'll sing another offertory song. So since you were so kind in that, we'll do another Christmas song, and it's kind of fun. And if Chris may get free on this one, he gets the Jericho jump on this one sometime toward the end. He gets to dance a little bit. JR just tries. He can't do much of it all. And, but I love that old song, Go Tell It on the Mountain, because I believe that's what God's called us to do. I got a red Bible when I was in elementary school, because I learned how to quote the Great Commission. I'd never seen a red Bible before. But in Matthew, it tells us, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing and teaching them in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I've commanded you. And lo, I'm with you always, even until the end of the earth. When that teacher gave me that red Bible in a little independent Baptist church in Alabama, and I learned those two verses, I never dreamed that God would allow me to go to the nations. And I've been to 47 nations. Nobody's ever heard of us. Nobody's ever heard of our school. But it is amazing to me how God will take insignificant people from insignificant places and sometimes choose to do very significant things. It happened in Bethlehem. I mean, right up the road, 3 miles, is Jerusalem. But God picked Bethlehem.
And I don't know you, but God may be picking you today to do something significant in this world you never dreamed. But the ultimate call on all of us is that great commission, is to go tell it on the mountain.
Happy day, happy day, hey, 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 hey. Ha, ha, ha. You're right. He can't dance. We'll give you an A for effort, okay? Haven't they done a phenomenal job today? Haven't they? Boy, how refreshing it is to see young people take the gifts and the talents they have and just honor God with them, okay? And so we want to be good to this group today, okay? We want to make an investment into them, and we want to be generous. We want to be cheerful givers, okay? Because the bus doesn't run on air, okay? And so they're going to Israel, and so as we give this morning, we're sending them out. And I tell you what, I'd love to be in Bethlehem and hear them sing over there. All right, so let's pray. Our ushers are going to come, and we're just going to give as an act of worship and thanksgiving to the Father. Father, we are grateful today for this time of worship. Father, for the opportunity to praise you and to lift your name up. And we're grateful that you sent this group to us today, these young people. We thank you for Roger and his investment in them. Thank you for the impact he's had over the years in thousands of people's lives. And so, Lord, as we give today, Father, use these gifts as an encouragement to them, as they've encouraged us, and bless them in their journeys ahead. In Jesus' name, amen. Yeah, just make the check out to us, and then we will cut them a check, okay? If you're writing a check. Cash always works.
Thank you, Pastor. Thank you so much. Tonight we'll be at First Baptist Jonesboro. We'll be at Stephen's dad's church. And then we make our way to Israel, and 2 weeks from today we'll be in Columbus. No, we'll be in, where are we going to be? Trustville, Alabama on Sunday morning, and Sunday night we'll be in Oneonta, Alabama. You can follow our schedule. We do about 150 of these a year. If you go to Facebook and just type in Voices of Mobile and be our friend there, and you like our page, we'd like for you to do that. Lots of people follow us there. In the lobby, you'll find our display table, and without it, we really could not travel, because it helps us buy our meals and all kinds of things. But this is Christmas at the University of Mobile. It's a DVD. We have about 200 in the choir, about 60 in the orchestra, and all of these groups. We have every style group you can imagine, from Celtic women to worship to voices to just all kinds of groups. It's just quite amazing. Every year on Daystar, the television network, it goes on, I think it went to 23rd of December. They broadcast it all over the world. It is a DVD, and you'll see all the things, the University of Mobile. This is our newest album. It's the Christmas album, but we put a couple of bonus things on it. We've only had a couple, not quite a couple months, but we did put Van's song on here, Happy. It's on here. But you can hear Joy to the World and Go Tell on the Mountain. You can hear Mary, Did You Know? Beautiful song. His name is Jesus, a Holy Night, Happy. And the song that we're about to sing is not a Christmas song. You can hear it on here too. So all of our CDs are $10 a piece. We try to make them affordable. We have 7 of them back there. They're $10 a piece. You can buy any 3 of them for $20. This is the newest one, called Here in This House. We did a salute to my friend Andre Crouch, also, who passed away this past year. And this is a T-shirt back there that says, You Thought I Was Worth Saving, which is a big song in our program. Now, we put everything, I just showed you a few, we put everything in a red bag. If you want all the CDs and the shirt and the DVD, all of that sells for $80. It's about $125. Or you can buy them individually. $10 a piece, 3 for 20. And make a check to the University of Mobile. You can pay cash. Use any major credit card. You can even donate on a credit card if you'd like to. People do that all the time. They're prepared to give. But all of that will be in the lobby. If you want everything, just say, give me a red bag, and they'll do it to you. Give it to you right out there. If you've been to Israel, you know what they do to you when you're driving into Jerusalem. You can't land in Jerusalem. You land in Tel Aviv, and you take the bus into Jerusalem. And you're so interested, if you've never been, you're looking at the, and all of a sudden this music starts on the bus. And they catch you every time. The hair stands up in the back of my neck every time I go. And they start playing this as you enter Jerusalem. I mean, it's a moment. But it's a moment I'm going to steal from that bus driver this year, because they're not going to play our music. our music. We're going to do our own music, and I'm anxious for them to experience this next week. I think it'll be Wednesday. Is that right? Yeah, Wednesday or Thursday when we drive into Jerusalem. So on our bus, they're not going to play that music. We're going to sing this song. And it's on our newest album out there, too. When we sing this song, then they'll come to the end of the service. Thank you again for being so kind to us today. We enjoyed very much being at Mabel White today. Some of you will know this song. It is Jerusalem.
Jerusalem, I want to rest.
I think you liked it. I think you did. I think you did. You know, usually we close our worship service out with a time of response. And, you know, maybe you're here today and you came in and you're one of these people that Roger was talking about earlier in the service. And everything seems to be turned upside down and you're trying to find the right side up again. Maybe you need somebody to pray with you. Maybe you need someone to encourage you. Maybe you have questions about what it means to be a Christian, about what it means to be a member of our church or whatever. I'm going to pray, and when I'm through, you can go out these doors and turn left, go down the hallway down here. And there's a room down there, and there'll be some people standing outside, and they're waiting on you. And they'll be happy to talk with you, to pray with you, to encourage you, and to answer whatever questions that you may have, okay? Also, we're going to have a budget discussion meeting in room 106 as soon as we're done here. And they've had it out there for a couple weeks for you to look at. And so finance team will be down there, and they'll have a time of explanation and question and answer, okay? Thank you again for coming. Thank you. And we pray for you guys as you travel. And don't forget to stop by the product table out there in the lobby. I know you're going to want some CDs and DVDs and all that kind of good stuff. Okay, let me pray. Father, we are grateful for today. Thank you for what we have seen and what we have heard. And we pray today that you will bless this group as they travel. We pray a hedge of protection around them, Lord, that you will use them to reflect you as they travel abroad. And then we pray this week as we scatter throughout central Georgia into the streets and the lanes of our city. And Father, may we be found faithful, compelling people to come in, that your house may be filled. In Jesus' name, amen.